Hey guys, I just wanted to give you a quick update about what's going on in the tube travel community. Yesterday morning, Hyperloop One released a video of their first full-scale test, and I'm really excited about this because it shows that people are not just talking about tube travel, but they're actually trying to make it happen. Not only that, but we're seeing a lot of competition between Hyperloop One and Hyperloop Transportation Technologies. Both of these companies have set goals of implementing the first systems within 3 or 4 years, and I'm sure they have to fight pretty hard for investor money and media attention, but the market for this is huge, so I don't really see any reasons why they can't both succeed. I think the competition is more about who can do it first. So it's pretty clear that H1 and HTT are front runners in the race for tube travel, but there's actually another company I wanted to talk about that might hold even more promise. And this company is called Hyper Chariot. They launched about a month ago, so you could argue that they're getting into the game kind of late, but they actually have a head start because they're a licensee of the ET3 consortium. ET3 has been developing this technology for 20 years. Licensees have been building and testing their ideas and contributing to a pool of intellectual property that can be used by any of the other licensees of ET3. So keeping this in mind, I think Hyper Chariot has a good chance of competing with H1 and HTT. Also, there are a couple major ways that Hyper Chariot sets itself apart, probably the most important of which is their tube diameter, which is 1.5 meters. On the other hand, Hyperloop One is looking at 3.5 meters, and obviously 3.5 meters is going to be a lot roomier than 1.5, but if you think about how cost varies with tube diameter, H1 system is probably going to be about 5 to 6 times more expensive to build. And since cost is usually the biggest roadblock to infrastructure projects, Hyper Chariot will definitely have an advantage in funding their system. The other thing that I really like about Hyper Chariot is their business strategy. It looks like H1 and HTT are not planning on making any revenue until their full-scale systems are built, which could be a while. But Hyper Chariot has plans to start making revenue by 2018. They're planning to build a virtual reality experience to show people what it would feel like to ride in their system. And by 2021, they plan to build a 3-mile-long tube as an amusement park ride that would launch people through at 400 miles per hour. I think the genius in this strategy is that it allows both progress and profit to be made without risking huge upfront costs. So if Hyper Chariot is successful in building these profitable systems, investors will have all of the proof they need, and a system between two major cities and eventually a global network would be inevitable. Finally, I want to say congratulations to Hyperloop One for a successful full-scale test, and I'm looking forward to seeing any new developments with HTT or Hyper Chariot in the next few months. If you are in a position to invest in tube travel, I highly recommend these companies because I really do think they'll be successful. On the other hand, if you're not in a position to invest, just talk about the concept. There are plenty of people who still don't know about tube travel, so you can have an impact just by spreading awareness. And as always, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time on Tube Travel.